We asked ourselves whether adjuvant and concurrent temozolomide would improve survival in patients without 1p19q loss and anaplastic glioma. And we set up a trial to address this. This was a 2x2 design type of study in which we first asked the question whether concurrent temozolomide would make a difference, and the second question was whether adjuvant temozolomide would make a difference. That was a trial design that required 750 patients, and we realized that we needed to collaborate across the countries, across continents to make the trial possible. We enrolled in 8 years 750 patients. We had to screen 1400 patients in that, and we were awaiting the outcome of the study to happen in 2022 or 2024. But very much to our surprise, a planned interim analysis for efficacy turned out to be positive. This interim analysis was done after 41% of events had occurred. At that time, enrollment was already completed. And very much to our surprise, the IDMC recommended us to release the data on adjuvant temozolomide. And here's the reason why. They noticed that 5-year survival increased from 44% in patients without adjuvant temozolomide to 56% of patients that were treated with adjuvant temozolomide. That's a huge increase, reflecting a hazard ratio of 0.64 and a p-value of 0.003. That means now that adjuvant temozolomide should be part of the standard of care of these patients given after radiation therapy. We do not know what the role is of concurrent temozolomide. That part of this treatment is still blinded, and we do not know the answer to that. We need to follow the patients further to get those answers.